YouTube, what is going on, guys? Thank you guys for checking out another one of my videos on this channel. Today we got a vlog for you guys. I can't help it. Every now and then I just do this just for fun. It's like a stress reliever. These are the best wallets, I swear.
Organic.
All organic.
Look at the difference when you buy organic strawberries versus like the ones that are sprayed with all that shit. Look how little they are and like raggedy they look.
Guys, I promise. Getting this personal trainer for her for Christmas, best decision ever. It's changed our life, not just on a working out level, just on a lifestyle level, man. Eating healthy. Remember that post that you posted on Facebook?
Oh, something about you will die for your kids, but will you stay healthy for them?
Damn. Of course you would die for your kids, but would you stay healthy for them? You know, at the same time, if you're not living a healthy lifestyle, you're killing yourself. Some deep thinking, some deep thoughts. I'm gonna show you guys in a little bit what she cooks, because the food, like, is delicious. And Sprouts, by the way. So we'll go to, what's your store? Sprouts?
Whole Foods.
Whole Foods.
Aldi's. Walmart's been stepping their game up.
Trader Joe's.
Yeah.
Trader Joe's, y'all. All right, guys, it is time to show you guys how my wife gets in her bag. I'm gonna let y'all know right now, I ain't got one of those wives that don't know how to cook. I ain't got one of those. My wife is golden. Let me show y'all. Y'all stop playing.
Got him.
Babe, can you explain what it is real quick?
It's brown rice pasta with broccoli, mushrooms, tomatoes, tomato sauce, spinach, and grilled chicken.
Ooh. Healthy. Healthy, but delicious. All right, this might or might not be released. Ooh, new trimmers, new guards. Y'all, they not playing with me, bro.
Hey, guys. Hard lemonade and stuff.
This is Chastity. This is the founder of Fayette Masson.
Self-made the brand.
Self-made the brand. Guys, look at this setup. I literally just put this webcam right there, pointing it down. If you haven't seen the unboxing of these beautiful, amazing, look how gorgeous. Look at the rubber grip on them. Probably the blade is next level. This is not the Graphite 2.0, this is the DLC. These are probably the most premium feeling trimmers I've ever felt in my hand. Patty Cuts trimmers, one of my favorite barbers in the industry. These don't come out till April, guys. I'm gonna use them at some point. If you didn't check out the unboxing, I actually had Patty Cuts on the live stream. We unbox these live. What's going on here?
Boy.
You doing yoga?
Yeah.
Just a little bit to bring that in.
Is it relaxing?
It's hard.
It's hard?
Not when you come to talk to us.
Oh, sorry, I'm out. All right, guys, so today is a busy day. We have the workout, wife's with her trainer over at her gym. She goes to a separate gym. I gotta sync up with our team that manages Amazon, Shopify, and kind of sync with them, see where we're at with different tasks and stuff. Gotta upload a video, gotta work with the accountants. It's tax season, you guys know how that is. In the midst of trying to purchase a home, so trying to close on it. I think one of the things I want to teach you guys today is how to buy a house as a barber. So we'll talk about that a little bit later. If you're not in the stock market the past couple weeks, that's a good thing. Today, looks like the stock market's making a little bit of a comeback. This month alone, I'm down like $20,000, guys. This is why when you're in the stock market, I'd rather invest in long term. Because if I was day trading and I was trading last week, probably wouldn't be making a video right now. I'd be depressed. All right, YouTube. So I just dropped a YouTube video. That was a pain in the butt because I reacted to somebody. You know, I do the series reacting to barber tutorials with no views. One of the risks with doing that series is a lot of times newer YouTube barbers, they don't know about monetization, copyright, the beats that they use and the instrumentals that they use in the background. A lot of times they'll get flagged and that can cause issues with your channel, but they don't know it because their channel's not monetized yet a lot of times. So my channel gets flagged. So today's channel got flagged. I dropped it anyways. I just wanted to get the content out. Hopefully he gets a whole bunch of subscribers and stuff. But guess what? I went to the gym earlier today and I did weights. Today I did back and biceps. I'm going back to the gym right now to do cardio. So I'm gonna do stair climbers for about a half hour. Kendrick, so The blade is supposed to be a lot smoother. That's one thing that Patty was telling me.
Bro, because it's like some type of graphite. Like, I know it's hard to see in the camera, but like, this is definitely, different. They definitely did a good job.
The quality is crazy,
grip,
right?
The grip is crazy. It's like Michelin tire tread on this joint, bro. For real.
Do you have any appointments today?
Yeah, right now.
Oh, okay. Will you cut with them so we can vlog it? All right. So I don't have a client today, so my dog Kendra about to show us what these do.
All right. Let's see.
Here we go.
Whoa, I tell you what.
How they feel? They feel good?
Bro, this rubber grip part and this matte paint is dope, bro. It feels like a premium clipper, bro.
That's why I said don't sleep on the paint either. Like the quality.
Like the paint or the quality is definitely dope, bro. And as always, as the other scales in the body is just crazy, but this rubber part is like,
I'm just getting home. Got a meeting. I got to jump on real quick. I don't know if you guys have seen the craziness with Rocket. You guys into the stock market at all? I got into Rocket. I'm riding the wave up. I'm going to get out. I don't have no diamond hands. I do not recommend you trade these meme stocks. Lost a lot of money to them. I'm trying to make some of it back this time around. It's crazy how the pandemic has woken people up, man, into investing more and stuff. I was just talking to one of the barbers at the shop into paying themselves first, but long-term investing. Put your first haircut a day into the stock market. You know what I mean? Pay yourself first. Save that money. Put your first haircut a day into the stock market. If you haven't gotten in the market, the younger you start, the better, guys. You can create your own retirement plan. You don't need a job, a W-2 to do that, guys. You could do it as a barber. Put your money in there, get educated on it, pay yourself first.
What's this? We back in the gym for a tour day.
I want to talk to you guys about the whole real estate thing, buying your first house as a barber. First, I gotta get in this tour day. I'm gonna get cardio in. Earlier today we did shoulders. I was at 225 when I started this journey. That was about a month ago. I got a physical. I was 225. Now I'm at about 217, so I'm doing really, really good. I want to get to about 210. I feel at 210 I'm gonna be looking really, really nice. I'm putting this in the video just to show y'all, man, you got to celebrate the process.
Yo, I want to shout out my friend Hernandez. He's a barber here in Florida. He has a product line called Tsunami, and you can see his 360 wave polish, and he's doing a finishing mousse. It's one of the popular things for waivers. We talk about, growth and different streams of income. And I tell people all the time, man, like barbers don't sell a lot of product for whatever reason. And I don't think they understand the power of product. Even if you sell one of these a day, man, even if it's not your own brand, even if you sell one of these a day and you keep re-upping, you keep reinvesting, it compounds into, two or three a day, and those returns compound. Before you know it, man, you got a hell of a stream of income, and word of mouth is spreading for you, just like word of mouth works with building clientele. It works with your products. Yeah, I'm going to the gym, and then we'll talk real estate.
All right, gotta get a bang before the workout. I don't know if you guys know this, but this is my daily driver. This is my baby. Car's probably worth like $3,000, maybe $3,000. Right.
My wife drives a really nice car. She has a Tesla, but she pays for it. That's her car. She pays for it. She got her own money. For me, I haven't upgraded the car, man, because why? I need something to get me from place A to B. I feel like it's time to get the car that I want. I'm a splurge, but for now, the way these tax bills look, I don't want to buy nothing for myself. But for real, man, some of you guys let materialistic things, man, hold you back from long-term growth, man, from things that matter. You feel me? I'm not the type of person that says, be super frugal, don't spend money on anything. But I think you gotta balance your expenses with your income. Like, my income, to me, is not a reflection of what my expenses should be. My expenses are based on my lifestyle, and a lot of times, man, my expenses are based on my happiness. You know what I mean? Like, if I'm happy, going to the gym, spending time with my family, rocking a t-shirt, some joggers, getting a haircut every once in a while, I'm still happy doing all that. I like making content. I like doing YouTube. I like cutting hair. And you don't got to spend a lot of money doing all that stuff. I'm happy traveling. And I can afford to travel a lot more than most people because I got my together. And a lot of times I don't got to pay for my travel because of my credit cards, my points. I can't remember the last time I spent money on a vacation. Most of the time, my points paid for it. When your expenses don't follow your income, you be feeling free. You be feeling free. And that's kind of priceless. So let's talk about why you should buy real estate. There's a few reasons. You can make money with real estate through appreciation, through equity, through cash flow, and tax incentives. Okay. Now, a lot of people don't understand that taxes are, besides your house, the biggest expense of your life. If you're making a decent income, 50, 60, 70, 100,000, you are paying some taxes. You're paying, especially if you're self-employed, you're paying 15% just on self-employed tax, plus whatever the federal income tax is. There's school taxes, there's sales taxes. Man, there's so many damn taxes. So think about that. A lot of you guys think to pay less taxes, you do write-offs, but then that affects whether you can buy a house or not. You can't write everything off and show no income because you don't want to pay taxes, because then you can't buy nothing. You're not worth nothing. There's no long-term growth doing that. But when you have a business or you have real estate, there are things like depreciation that help lower your tax bill, but still shows as income. This is why rich people buy a lot of real estate. This is why rich people buy businesses. It's not always because of the income. Sometimes they buy these things just to help them pay less taxes. Taxes are super important, and with real estate, there's a lot of amazing benefits when it comes to taxes. You have cash flow, and I'm not flicking you guys off. I'm gonna put half a finger here so y'all don't think I'm flicking you off. You have cash flow, right? So if you are renting the property out, the income that you're getting from the rent that you're charging to a tenant minus your expenses is positive, then you have a cash flow. That is another benefit of real estate. Another benefit is equity pay down. So if you got a tenant in that house and they're paying $1,200 a month, your mortgage is $800. Maybe $600 of it is going towards equity. Every single month, you're building $600 a month in net worth because you're paying down that property's debt, which is equity for you. Eventually, somebody else pays off the house. Now you got a house worth $300,000. Your net worth is $300,000 now, and you didn't pay for that house. Somebody else did. The other thing is appreciation. I think right now, man, houses are up like 20% on average everywhere. It's crazy. Let's say you own $1 million house a year ago. Appreciation in your market has gone up 20%, which is rare. If it's, for easy math, 10%, your net worth is going up $100,000 every single year with that $1 million property. This is why some people, they try to buy the most house that they can afford so that appreciation works in their favor. You're not supposed to do that because there's bad markets where houses depreciate. But in the long term, houses always, the trajectory is like this, but going up. You see what I'm saying? But this is why you want to get into real estate. Now, how do you do it as a barber? The way that you do it as a barber is all dependent on how you get paid. If you get paid a W-2, it's easy. You go to a bank or you go to a mortgage broker, they'll qualify you for how much house you get. What they'll do is they'll say you can get approved on 40 to 45% of your income. These are numbers I'm throwing out there. It changes. In the academy, I brought my mortgage broker on and he explained the exact numbers, but I'm gonna give you guys a ballpark number, 40 to 45% of your income. So if you make 10 grand a month, you can afford a mortgage of $4,000 a month. Now that's not really what you can afford, that's what you can get approved for, because everybody has a different lifestyle. Some people like to travel a lot, some people eat out a lot, and just because you can get approved for a $4,000 mortgage doesn't mean you should be going and doing that if it doesn't make sense for your lifestyle. That's $4,000 a month. So 40 to 45% of your income. Now, what if you have a car payment of $1,000 a month because you making 10 grand a month, you know what I'm saying? You balling, you want to get yourself a nice Beamer, M5 or something clean like that, 7 series, and you got a $1,000 car payment. Well, now, instead of being able to get approved on a $4,000 mortgage, you got to minus that $1,000 car payment. Now you can only get approved for $3,000. Let's say you got student loans. You got student loans of $500 a month. Guess what? Now you can't get approved on a $3,000 house. Now you can only get approved on a $2,500 house. Oh, let's say you have credit card bills. You owe $10,000 in credit cards and your payments are like $200 a month. Now instead of $2,500, you can only get approved for a mortgage that's $2,300. See what I'm saying? And so a lot of people, they ball out with cars, they write off a bunch of taxes, and then they go try to buy a house and they can't get approved for nothing. Because you wrote off so much that instead of making $100,000 a year, it shows that you made $50,000 a year. It's called DTI, debt to income. So now your DTI has changed because you got this $1,000 car payment and you wrote off so much. So now you can only get approved on a mortgage of $1,000 a month. I mean, there's not a lot of areas where you can buy a house with a mortgage that's $1,000. It's very hard to find, even in Tampa. If you are self-employed, let's say you do booth rent and you get a 1099, then you need 2 years of income under the same job, the same LLC, the same S Corp. You need 2 years of income as well. On top of that, the way that they look at your income is the average of the 2 years. That's what the income that they'll base when they're trying to get you approved for a mortgage. So hopefully that makes sense.
Of course, the most important thing,
your credit score. Like, there's different types of mortgages. Typically, the better your credit, the better rates you're going to get, the higher chance you're going to get approved. If you have like a 5.8, a 600, a 620, something like that, a lower credit rate, there's still a chance you can get a mortgage, but you're going to pay way higher interest rates. That means you can afford less house. You can get approved on less house. So if your income at least isn't up there, then it's going to be harder for you to get a house, because if you got low income and your credit is shot, you're going to get approved for even less house. You want to have a decent credit score. You want to buy a house, you got money in the bank, and you want to buy a house. At the very least, you want to start the process of learning where you need to be at this time next year so you could buy a house. I would focus on getting you your own house first. I don't care what nobody says. There's 100% benefits in buying a house if you plan on living in that area for a decent amount of time. All right, guys. I think I covered everything. Love y'all. I hope you guys got some nuggets from this vlog. Let me know if you want to see some more vlogs. And we do daily content on this channel. I'll see y'all tomorrow.